today's video, I am going to be sharing with you my experience with a liquid nitrogen treatment, also known as cryotherapy. Did this treatment actually work? Did it get rid of my ugly, unattractive age spots? And would I do it again? Well, let's go find out. In layman terms, basically what the liquid nitrogen does is it damages the area. So you have an age spot, you don't want that. So what they do is they use the liquid nitrogen, it freezes the spot, thus damaging the area. It then over time begins to crust over, producing a scab, and eventually it falls off, and then it reveals beautiful, brand new, fresh, gorgeous skin. And that's what you want. Oh, and don't be distracted by my little distracting dot here. It's a little age spot.
And there I was, shooting a video with this unattractive little age spot. It was time to get rid of it. So here I am on day one. I just came home from having my liquid nitrogen treatment done. And as you can see, the age spot has been frozen and it's nice and red. I also had it done on my thighs, my lower leg, and one on my hand. So here I am on day two. You can see that the spot has gotten a lot darker. As for the ones on my thighs, not much has changed. They're very smooth and it just doesn't really look red. The one on my hand, it's just a little darker. And the one on my lower leg, well, that one kind of looked a little uglier, but just kind of on the rim of it. It wasn't like quite the whole thing. And that one also felt smooth. The one on my face was smooth as well. I thought for sure it was gonna be like kind of crusty and I was thinking it was gonna be more scabby-like, but it really wasn't. Since I had no scabs on my face, I went ahead and did my normal routine like always. I moisturized and put my primer and just did my normal makeup routine like always. Here you can see me adding some concealer, just trying to cover it up. And it was still smooth, nothing felt bumpy or crusty. And I just tried to cover up the best I could. But as you can see, I really couldn't. Now here I am on day three and it's starting to look a little better. I mean, it's looking darker, so that part's ugly, but it looks like it's getting smaller. Surprisingly, it's still really smooth. Now here I am on day five and I am starting to get excited. It's getting smaller. It doesn't look pretty, but it's definitely getting smaller and it's starting to get like flaky-ish. So I know it's almost over. That brand new beautiful skin is about to appear. And voila, here we are on day six. The liquid nitrogen worked perfectly, revealing brand new beautiful spot-free skin. I am so thrilled with the results on my face. So now let's stop and take a look at the other spots I had done. Here you can see the spot on my lower leg. It doesn't seem to be progressing quite as quickly as the one on my face did. This is actually day nine, and all you can see is one little section of that spot that's actually kind of red and looks like maybe something's gonna happen. But the rest of it just kind of seems like it's there and not much progress at all. As for my thighs, one of the spots seems like nothing's going on at all. The other one does seem to be fading a little bit, but not as much as I would have thought by day nine. I thought by day nine, it would have peeled off like the face and it would have been totally gone, but not so much. Now, as for my hand, you can see that it is kind of really red. Again, this is day nine. I thought by now we'd have a lot more progress, but it is what it is. I am hoping that because the whole spot is red, that it will eventually flake off and reveal beautiful new skin just like my face. Now, here I am 3 weeks later, revealing the true results of this liquid nitrogen treatment. As you can see here, the skin is no longer pink. The skin tone has now evened out and it looks like nothing ever occurred there. I am super excited about the results on my face. Another area that I am super excited about is my hand. Remember that ugly age spot I had there? Totally gone. The pinkness went away, the skin tone also evened out, and the results are absolutely beautiful. Now, I really wish that I can report that all my sunspots and age spots disappeared miraculously with this liquid nitrogen, but unfortunately, that was not the result. As you can see here, one of the sunspots that I had on my thigh, it didn't disappear. It faded quite a bit, but it didn't completely disappear. So I still have like a minor spot there. The other thigh, it didn't budge at all. Nothing happened. It basically stayed the same as the day I got there. So he treated it, yet nothing happened. And unfortunately, I had the same result with the age spot that I had on my lower leg. That one was kind of bigger. You could see my finger next to it. It was kind of a bigger age spot. And I hate to be negative. I don't like being negative, but I do want to be truthful. I feel like the procedure was kind of rushed. I felt like he was just kind of, you know, zapping away, but really quick like. He kind of took more time on my face, but everything else seemed to be kind of rushed. And I'm wondering if that contributed to the not so great results on some of the spots.
Now the question of the hour is, would I do this treatment again? And the answer is yes, absolutely yes. I would do it again, and as a matter of fact, this is my second time doing it. Now, would I go to the same dermatologist that did it the last time? Probably not. Based on my results, I think that I would probably look for a different dermatologist. I'd do more research. I would try to find someone who had amazing reviews and do a little bit more research on the dermatologist himself. Now, I'm not saying that the dermatologist that I went to didn't know what he was doing. He knew exactly what to do. However, because he rushed through the procedure, didn't take his time on every individual little spot, the results on some spots, not all of them, were unfortunately not what I expected. It's disappointing because I feel like because he rushed through it, now I have to find yet another dermatologist, make another appointment, and get the same procedure done for something that could have already been done. And I only bring that up because if you are going to go through this procedure, you want to make sure that it's done right. So keep in mind, the dermatologist that you choose to have this done with, it does make a difference. So take your time and make sure to find a really good dermatologist. Now, another point I want to talk about is the experience. Did this treatment hurt? Well, it does. A little bit. Not a lot. Just a little bit. I would say on a pain scale, between 1 and 10, I would say the pain level was maybe a 1 to 2. I guess it would depend how big the age spot is that they're getting rid of. Mine were pretty small, so he didn't have to stay on top of them very, very long. I'm assuming if you have a bigger age spot, maybe that would hurt. You do feel a bit of stinging after the procedure is done. After you leave the dermatology office, you might be walking to your car, whatever, you're still feeling it. You're feeling a little bit of stinging, kind of like if you scrape yourself and, you know, you scrape your skin and it feels kind of stinging. That's what it feels like. However, that doesn't last. By the next day, you're not feeling that anymore. Another point to talk about is that it does take time to heal. You're not gonna get this done and it is gone in 2-3 days. It definitely takes time to heal. So the reason I bring that up is if you don't want to be walking around with maybe spots on your face or wherever it is that you're having it done, keep in mind that you do need some time, I would say a week or two of healing time for that scab to completely come off. You don't want to pick it off, you know, you want it to happen naturally so the skin that comes in is nice and fresh and absolutely beautiful. You don't want to rush the process. So you do have to keep in mind that it is going to take some time and you want to allot for that time. If you don't want to be walking around with spots and what have you, maybe you have an event that you're going to, or you're, whatever the case, keep in mind it takes time to heal. So make sure that you plan it accordingly. So there you have it, guys. That is my personal, honest experience with liquid nitrogen. I hope this video was helpful, and I hope you got a lot of good information out of it. If you like what you see here, please be sure to like, subscribe, maybe even comment. That's all for today, guys. Thanks for watching, and see you at the next video. Bye-bye.